Anyone giving a press conference is forgiven. Those who don't are picked up. And this is all which is in the knowledge of everyone. So should this court just shut its eyes and allow a political party to face these challenges? Or it's not about the political party, it's about that voter of that common man, how to protect his right. Where the elections were held, serious questions are raised. It is all about the people, their right of vote.
Yes.
So how do we interpret the constitution in the light of whatever has happened? And the same had also happened in 2018. But the country was not governed under the constitution. The manner in which people have alleged that they didn't have level playing field. Now you have victims in every election, and the reality is known to everyone. How do we then interpret the constitution, allow the coercive apparatus to continue and achieve their purposes, or to interpret the constitution so that the people are not disenfranchised?
Yes.
That's the question.
Yes.
That reality, you see, is known to all of us.
Yes.
Anyone giving a press conference is forgiven. Those who don't are picked up. And this is all which is in the knowledge of everyone.
Yes.
So should this court just shut its eyes and allow a political party to face these challenges? Or it's not about the political party, it's about that voter of that common man, how to protect his right.
My lord, I agree with you, but I think the difference between what your lordship is saying and what the Chief Justice is saying, and you know, it's a recognized academic difference, is that his lordship, the Chief Justice, believes in a literal and a historical interpretation of the Constitution. That's a perfectly valid school of thought. I don't believe in that. I don't think that such an interpretation will be able to make the constitutional functional, but let me now move forward. But it's a genuine debate. It's a genuine debate.
As far as I am concerned.
जी सर, सर आप तो प्रोग्रेसिव इंटरप्रिटेशन,
प्रोग्रेसिव वो भी मैं बताऊंगी कि उसमें मैंने क्या किया.
Within a purposive interpretation of the constitution, no interpretation can be assigned to these words which converts the proportional representation system into a disproportionate representational system. So you cannot give it a literal meaning if that means that parties who have a certain representation in parliament get more than their representation.
I just told you an example. If the parties, if independents don't want to join it, they will be tilted.
So the answer to that is in the rules. I'll come to that.
The rules will not control the constitution.
Sir, एक आप जैसे ये, this has become a very famous example given by Justice Mansoor Ali Shah साहब कि 80% लोग independent हो जाते हैं, 90% let's say हो जाते हैं, और वो नहीं join करते कोई political party. आप क्या 10% को सारी सीटें दे देंगे?
आईन ये कहता है, इसलिए जवाब ये है, आईन ये कहता है, not कि मेरी मर्जी है या मुझे पसंद है. कि एक सेकंड ठहर जाइए ना, ऐसे आप आगे ना चले ना. इस मुल्क की धज्जियां उड़ा दी गई हैं क्योंकि आईन पे अमल नहीं होता है. ठीक है, मैंने ओथ लिया आईन पे, मैंने ये नहीं देखा गुड गवर्नेंस पोलिटिकल इस पे, मैंने सिंपल ओथ लिया आईन और लॉ पे. अब आप उसके तकाजे पूरे करें. आईन ये कहता है जिनने आईन बनाया आप जाके आईन अमेंड कर लें, या आईन कोई प्रोविजन डिक्लेयर्स अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल द बेसिक स्ट्रक्चर थ्योरी.
डिफरेंस बिटवीन हाउ योर लॉर्डशिप इज रीडिंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड हाउ आई एम रीडिंग द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज दैट बोथ ऑफ अस एग्री दैट द वर्ड्स ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन आर सीक्रेट, बट सर आर इंटरप्रिटेशन इज नॉट सीक्रेट.
यू नीड इंटरप्रिटेशन. आई डोंट.
कैन बी सब्जेक्ट टू ह्यूमन फैलिबिलिटी.
चलिए आगे बढ़ते हैं.
अगला पढ़े आप
बताइए फैसल साहब.
मिस्टर फैसल सिद्दीकी, it seems to me that the resolution of, because that hypothetical counterfactual has been, although I personally think that in those 3 days it would be Eid day for the independents, but so we won't in fact have that problem even on the counterfactual. But it seems to me that this dichotomy or apparent dichotomy between Sunni Ittehad versus PTI, for the purposes of paragraph D and for no other purpose,
yes,
I think the essence is now, it seems to me, boiling down simply to this: are we going to allow form to triumph over substance?
Yes.
That is the essence of, yes, the matter. And are we going to be so blinded by the harsh political reality, if you want to call it that, or the hard facts on the ground, that if the Election Commission on its own cascade of errors is channelizing, shoehorning people who are returned candidates of a political party into a quote-unquote independent status, subject to whatever council has to say on that, are we bound by that, or are we bound by what plainly is the intent of the paragraph? Look at the substance of it. What is the political party? If, as a matter of form, in the very unusual circumstances of this case, one hopes and prays that in no future election is a major political party unable to contest a general election on its own election symbol. But these are very highly unusual circumstances.
Anyone giving a press conference is forgiven. Those who don't are picked up. And this is all which is in the knowledge of everyone. So should this court just shut its eyes and allow a political party to face these challenges? Or it's not about the political party, it's about that voter of that common man. How to protect his right? The way the elections were held, serious questions are raised. It is all about the people, their right of vote.
Yes.
So how do we interpret the Constitution in the light of whatever has happened? And the same had also happened in 2018. But the country was not governed under the Constitution. The manner in which people have alleged that they didn't have level playing field. Now you have victims in every election, and the reality is known to everyone. How do we then interpret the Constitution, allow the coercive apparatus to continue and achieve their purposes, or to interpret the Constitution so that the people are not disenfranchised?
Yes.
That's the question.
Yes.
That reality, you see, is known to all of us.
Yes.
Anyone giving a press conference is forgiven. Those who don't are picked up. And this is all which is in the knowledge of everyone. So should this court just shut its eyes and allow a political party to face these challenges? Or it's not about the political party, it's about that voter of that common man. How to protect his right?
My Lord, I agree with you, but I think the difference between what your Lordship is saying and what the Chief Justice is saying, and you know, it's a recognized academic difference, is that His Lordship, the Chief Justice, believes in a literal and a historical interpretation of the Constitution. That's a perfectly valid school of thought. I don't believe in that. I don't think that such an interpretation will be able to make the constitutional functional, but let me now move forward. It's a genuine debate.
As far as I am concerned,
जी सर, आप तो प्रोग्रेसिव इंटरप्रिटेशन
प्रोग्रेसिव वो भी मैं बताऊंगी कि उसमें मैंने क्या किया।